Hello everyone, my name is Maartje and I'm here today for Cloud9 Crafts. Today I wanted to show you how to create some easy bookmarks with a big wow effect. For me the wow effect for these bookmarks, they come from the backgrounds that I'm going to create. And the backgrounds, they have sort of a faux watercolor look, which I'm going to create with a stencil. So the stencil, it is from Heavy Doodle and it is called Broad Strokes. And as you can see, it sort of has a watercolor look to it because the edges are jagged. There are multiple ways you can use this stencil and get really different looks. For my first background, I am going to use the stencil multiple times. So I am going to layer it and use different colors. The first layer of ink blending I did with Distress Oxide Salvaged Patina, and now I'm going to work on the second layer, and as you can see I shifted the stencil slightly. I have also adhered my background to my gloss media mat with some purple tape, and to make sure that the stencil does not move, I'm also adhering that with purple tape to my gloss media mat. So now on to the ink blending of the second layer, and for this I am using Distress Oxide Kitsch Flamingo. In a previous project I also used a combination of Kitsch Flamingo and Salvage Patina, and in that project I noticed what a beautiful color you get when you layer those two colors on top of each other. As I really liked that shade of purple the two colors create, I also wanted to make use of it for this background. For the ink blending, as always, I am using my Tailored Expressions blender brushes, and these are really my favorite. So now the ink blending of the second layer is done, so I will lift up the stencil and then you can see what a gorgeous effect it has. There are still a few strokes of white in the background, but I did not want them to be so stark white. So what I'm now going to do is I'm going to ink blend them with Distress Oxide Milled Lavender. But this time I am not using all the strokes of the stencil, but I am using the smaller ones. So those two that you saw just now at the top and are now at the bottom, those two are a bit smaller than the other ones, so I'm going to use them to fill up those white spots. And I must say, I'm really glad I did, because I really love the milled lavender in combination with the other colors already going on in the background. So now my first background is done, and out of each background I will create two bookmarks. For the second background I'm going to keep things a bit more simple, so I'm not going to layer the stencil and use it multiple times, I'm just going to do it this once. But this time I am going to do some sort of shading with the Cracked Pistachio and Squeezed Lemonade. So at the borders and also in the center I am using the Cracked Pistachio, and then in between the Cracked Pistachio I am using the Squeezed Lemonade. These two colors together also create a beautiful gradient, and they mix also very well. The reason I am also doing the Cracked Pistachio in the center is because again from one background I'm going to create two bookmarks. So both of the bookmarks, they will have the Cracked Pistachio at the sides and then the highlighted Squeezed Lemonade in the center. Currently I am making sure that the transition between the Cracked Pistachio and the Squeezed Lemonade is very smooth, so I was just going over it again with the Cracked Pistachio. And here you can see the finished result of my second background, and here they are also together. I'm really curious to hear which one you like most. Off camera I have trimmed both backgrounds down so I can get two bookmarks out of them. Now we can get started on the focal points for the bookmarks. For this I am using the In Focus Florals from MFD. I have die cut them twice out of white cardstock and stacked them on top of each other for a bit of dimension. I really love the elegant look of these flowers, and I think they go perfect with the backgrounds I have created. Then I have also stamped sentiments on mermaid cardstock from Lanvin with Versamark ink, and I heat set the white embossing powder. The sentiments are from the Itty Bitty Basics stamp set from MFT, and they also come with coordinating dice. The dice are called the Itty Bitty Strips, and as you can see there were two different designs and there are also two different widths. You could also leave the bookmarks like this, so adhere the flowers and the sentiment on top, but I really liked a white background around it, so that is what I'm going to do. To adhere my backgrounds on the white panel, I am using my tacky glue, and once I adhere things down, I also like to put an acrylic block on top to make sure that everything dries flat. As these are going to be bookmarks, I was also aware that I did not want too much dimension on the bookmarks because otherwise it could sort of get in trouble, I suppose, in the book. But I also do like to have dimension because it looks more interesting. So that is why I stacked the florals on top of each other, so I die-cut them twice. And I did the same thing with the sentiment. So these bookmarks, they do have a bit of dimension, but not too much. But of course you can also just leave it out and just keep everything in one layer and not stack things on top of each other. I think this design also works if you don't want to create bookmarks, but like a regular card. Then of course you would have more space, so you can also combine a couple of the florals together. When adhering these sentiment strips, I am just eyeballing if it is straight, but of course you can also use your T-ruler if you really want to be sure. What I sometimes tend to do with putting down the sentiment is I make sure that the bookmark is aligned with one of the grid lines on the glass media mat, so then I know the bookmark is straight and then it is also easier for me to put the sentiment down straight. As a final embellishment, I did want to put on some Nouveau Drops, and these are called White Blizzard. Nouveau Drops can be quite dimensional, and of course these are bookmarks, so you do not want to have too much dimension. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab the bookmark and tap it on top of something. In this case I'm just using the Nouveau Drops bottle, and this will flatten out the drops. I'm also going to try and show you the difference now. So the right one I have already tapped against the bottle, and the left one I did not do yet. And you can see that the drops on the right hand side are already more flat than on the left side. One thing I also like to do when I'm not sure where I want to put my drops, I will just grab some random sequins and I will lay them down on the bookmark and play around with the position. And when I am sure of the positions, I will just take a picture with my phone and then I will put the Nouveau Drops on the places where I put the sequins. So now the first two bookmarks are done and we can move on to the other two. For these ones I wanted to have a green border, so I used Cilantro cardstock from Lanvin. And off camera I've also stamped sentiments on black cardstock. And again, I did this with Versamark ink and I heat embossed white embossing powder. For the focal points, I am also using the In Focus florals from MFT. And I have die-carded out of white cardstock and also out of sticky note cardstock and cilantro cardstock. And then for some flowers in the, or the leaves in the background, I must say, I just die-carded from vellum. If you also would like to die-cut something out of vellum, I also have a little tip for you. As vellum is quite thin, especially compared to the other cardstock I was using, I noticed that the die, it did not really make the best impression. So what I did for my second vellum leaves, I also put some cardstock underneath, so the die-cutting machine would put a bit more pressure on it, and then you would get a nicer result. So for one set of the leaves, you do not really have that rounded edge on the leaves because I did not put in that extra cardstock. And for the other one, where I did, you do have that nice rounded edge. I hope that was clear, and if it was not, also feel free to ask me anything in the comments. As the sentiments are black, but there was not anything else black on the bookmark, I wanted to make sure that everything tied together, so I decided to add some black splatters. And I did this by diluting Distress Ink Black Soothe with water, and then I just tapped against my paintbrush to create the splatters. For adhering the vellum leaves, I was actually trying out two different things. So for this first bookmark, I thought maybe it will be enough to just put glue behind those green leaves and maybe it will also hold down the vellum leaves. But in the end, it was not enough, so I also had to put some glue behind the vellum leaves. So for my second bookmark, I decided to put some glossy accents on those vellum leaves right away to make sure that everything will be adhered down well. And as you know, it can be quite difficult to adhere vellum without the glue showing through. But I find that when you use glossy accents and you just apply a small drop, then it will be barely visible. The vellum leaves on these bookmarks, they are quite subtle, but I do feel that it fills up the design quite nicely and it gives that bit of extra that it needed. And because I also already added splatters to the background, I'm also not going to add any nouveau drops or sequins or whatever, but I will just keep it like this. I really hope that you like these bookmarks and you also enjoyed watching this video. Remember to like and subscribe if you did. Thank you so much for watching and see you next time.